name figure that became the foundation of the Morgan horse breed. Versatility is the hallmark of the Morgan breed. You'll see them not only in driving classes, but riding classes here at Big E. They're in saddle seat, hunt seat, western seat, popular in western dressage and many other disciplines. A very versatile breed, and we're glad to have them as part of our Big E Horse Show. A beautiful Morgan horse in our opening class.
Extend the trot, please. Show the extended trot. And down to the pleasure trot, please. And we'll ask you a pleasure trot right into center ring and line up. This has been our open pleasure 2- and 4-wheeled vehicle. Attendants may come in. Results official now in class number 70, our open pleasure driving 2- and 4-wheeled vehicle. We'll congratulate our winner today, number 529. It's Winterset time after time. David Champion drove to victory today for Claire Simpson of East Haddam, Connecticut. Second award to 546, King Leo. Olivia Marker Pittock shows for Ann Butler of Crosswicks, New Jersey. There they go. Once again, the winner of the open pleasure driving for the 2- and 4-wheeled vehicle class will congratulate Winterset time after time. Dan the Champion drove to victory today for Claire Simpson. Next up on the schedule is class number 71. It is the Ladies English Pleasure Horse Open. Expecting 7 in this one. Thank you. pass is complete. Judging underway at the trap, please. Extended trot, please. Show the extended trot. Please. At a walk, please. Canter, please. Show at the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Reverse and trot, please. Extended trot, please. Show it the extended trot. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Canter, please. Show at the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. And thank you very much, driver. Riders, we're asking to trot right into center ring and line up. This has been the Ladies English Pleasure. The results official now in class number 71, our ladies English Pleasure Horse Open. We'll congratulate our winner this afternoon, number 679. That's apparently to me only. Casey Sikosha shows for Paul Otto of Raleigh, North Carolina. Second place, we'll congratulate 739. It's Benedetto. Aaron McCracken shows for Pat Johnson of Blairstown, New Jersey. Third award of 538, SBR Hot Rod. Sharon Stoltz, the owner rider from East Hampton, Connecticut. Into fourth, 708, Lady Ella Fitzgerald. Ann Port, the owner and rider from Waterford, Connecticut. Fifth to number 612, There's Nuttin' Butter. Caitlin Flannery shows for Lillian Gilpin of Plimpton, Massachusetts. And the sixth award to 491, T.F. Boone Small Diamond. Christina Fuller shows for Brandy Cario of Middleborough, Massachusetts. Here they come down Big E Victory Lane. Please give it up for our winner once again, apparent to me only, Casey Sikosha, Road to Victory for Paul Otto of Raleigh, North Carolina. Next up on the schedule, class 72. It is our saddle seat equitation for our 13 and under riders. We are expecting three in this one. Here they come.
So I've got a trivia question for you as this class comes in and a chance for somebody to win a Big E prize pack here this afternoon. Up on the screen, there's our trivia question. How many people attended opening weekend at the Big E? How many people came last weekend to the Big E? Text the keyword to 22333. If you think it was 87,092, text Big E 87. If you think it was 118,627, text Big E 118. Or 274,000, type Big E 274 and send that to the number 22333. Those instructions up on the screen now.
Thank you, Mark. Underway now with the saddle seat equitation, 13 and under at the trot, please. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Canter, please. Show at the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. reverse, and trot, please.
So this class is a little different than the ones you've been watching. This is an equitation class. That means our judge is judging the rider's performance and control of horse instead of evaluating the horse. Equitation refers to the practice or the art of horse riding or horsemanship. Our judge looking at the equitation rider's position while they're on the horse, their ability to ride correctly and use effective aids in the show ring. A good equitation rider is always in balance with their horse, maintaining a correct position in every gait, in every movement. They possess a commanding but relaxed presence in the show ring. Our judge evaluating the riders in this class, the equitation riders.
Thank you, riders. Down to the walk, please. Canter, please. Show at the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. And thank you very much, riders. We're asking to trot right into center ring and line up. This has been our saddle seat equitation 13 and under.
You'll notice after these equitation riders line up, our judge will walk the line up and take a closer look at all of these riders, because evaluating the horse and the art of horsemanship in our equitation class, the rider's poise goes into that evaluation, as well as the cleanliness and polish of the horse, the rider, and the equipment. You'll probably notice our equitation riders sit up a little straighter, a little more polished than in our other classes where the horse is being judged, but all of that a factor in determining an equitation winner. Hey, don't forget about our trivia question right now. We're asking, how many people do you think attended opening weekend here at the Big E? That's up on the screen right now. Text your answer. Text the keyword to 22333. Was it Big E 87 for a little over 87,000 people? Big E 118 for a little over 118,000? Our Big E 274 for over 274,000. Text your answer to 22333. How many people attended opening weekend last weekend here at the Big E?
Our results official now in class number 72, our saddle seat equitation 13 and under. First place in Blue Ribbon Honors, will congratulate 745. It's Bella Jed of Merrimack, New Hampshire. Second place, 626, Anna Marola of Pittstown, New Jersey. And in third, 640, Charlotte Towery of Cranford, New Jersey. Here they come, down Victory Lane, our saddle seat equitation 13 and under winner, Bella Jett, taking her blue ribbon back to Merrimack, New Hampshire. Next up on the schedule, we'll call to the ring class number 73 from the American Saddlebred Division. It is the Western Country Pleasure Championship. Lone entry making their way in. My apologies, should be the Morgan Classic Pleasure Junior Horse. My apologies. Class is complete and underway at the pleasure trot, please. Up to the road trot, please. Up to the road trot. Thank you. Rider down to the walk, please. At a walk, please. Canter, please. Show it the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Reverse and pleasure trot, please. Up to the road trot, please. Thank you. Down to the walk, please. Canter, please. Show it the canter. And thank you, rider. Down to the walk, please. Everyone that's going to join us at center ring and line up, if you would trot right into line, Morgan Classic Pleasure Junior Horse, we've called for the lineup. Results official now in class 142, our Morgan Classic Pleasure for the junior horses. We'll congratulate our winner, number 685. It's SSLLC Empire. Kathleen Jensen rides for Kevin Shengren of Hershey, Pennsylvania. Here's another look at the winner of the Morgan Classic Pleasure Junior Horse Class. We'll congratulate once again SSLLC Empire and Kathleen Jensen. She rode to victory today for Kevin Shengren of Hershey, Pennsylvania. Next up on the schedule is class number 73 from the American Saddlebred Division. It is the Western Country Pleasure Championship. While this class is making its way in, I'm going to turn it over to my colleague, Mark Farrar.
Thank you, Todd. I'm down here in front of Section 12 with Lyle and Vicky. Lyle is making his first trip to the Big E. Vicky comes every year, like several times during the fair each year. But she's brought Lyle this year for his first trip to the Big E, his first horse show he's never ridden. But we're going to give him a chance to answer our trivia question and earn a free ride or drive at a local stable. So the trivia question was, how many people attended opening weekend here at the Big E? Was it 87,092, 118, 627, or 274, 296?
274, 296.
So he goes with 274, 296. What'd the crowd say, Todd?
Mark, the crowd said 118,627.
Well, the crowd is wrong, and Lyle is right. It was 274,296 total attendance for opening weekend. What's significant about that? Both Friday and Saturday, we set attendance records here at the Big E with 87,000 on Friday and over 118,000 on Saturday alone for attendance records. So thank you to everybody who's come to the Big E. Congratulations, guys, on winning our trivia.
So underway now with the Western Country Pleasure Championship, underway at the jog. Moving on to the lope, please, if you would, rider, on to the lope, please. Rock, please. Down to the rock, please. Halt and stand, please. Reverse and walk, please. halt and stand, please. Lope, please. At the lope, please. Down to the jog, please. At a jog, please. And thank you very much, Ryder Russ. Going to jog right into center ring and line up. This has been the Western Country Pleasure Championship for our American Saddlebred. Results official now in class number 73, our American Saddlebred Western Country Pleasure Championship. Our champion will congratulate 731. It's first one up. Catherine Schanefeld chose for Patricia Schanefeld of Greenwich, Connecticut.
Hey, while you're watching our horse show today, if you have questions about the horse show or questions about what you see in the show ring, you can text your questions to us. Be sure to put the word Big E first, put Big E, then a space, followed by your question, and send it to the number 22333. So text us your questions to the number 22333. Just start it with Big E, then a space, and then your question. That information's up on the big screen right now.
Here's a look at the winner of our Saddlebred Western Country Pleasure Championship. It's first one up, and Catherine Schanefeld. She rode to victory today for Patricia Schanefeld of Greenwich, Connecticut. Next up on the schedule is class number 74, a Roadster Pony Junior Exhibitor class. Lone entry making their way in. Ball Pass is complete. Judging underway at the jog trot, please. Second gear rider up to the road gate. Back to the jog trot, please. At the jog trot. Reverse and continue at the jog trot, please. Second gear up to the road gate. Show it speed. Let him go. Back to the jog trot, please. Back to the jog trot, please. And thank you very much, Ryder Ruskin, to join us at center ring for the lineup. This has been our Roadster Pony Junior Exhibitor. Results are official now in Class 74, our Roadster Pony Junior Exhibitor class. We'll congratulate our winner, 479, at Silver Oaks, Kimora Lee. Ellie Riva shows for Elaine Gregory of Brookfield, Vermont. Here they come down Victory Lane, our Silver Oaks, Kimora Lee. Ellie Riva rode to victory for Elaine Gregory of Brookfield, Vermont, our winners today. Next up on the schedule is class number 75. We're returning to the Morgan Division and welcoming to the ring the Hunter Pleasure Championship. Four entries making their way in. Toss is complete. Judging underway at the trot, please. Extend the trot, please. Show the extended trot. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Canter, please. Show it the canter. Extend the canter, please. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Reverse and trot, please. Extend the trot, please. Show it the extended trot. Walk, please. And a walk, please. Canter, please. Show it the canter. Extend the canter, please. Walk, please. Down. Down to the walk, please. And thank you very much, Riders. We're going to trot right into center ring and line up. This has been our Morgan Hunter Pleasure Championship. Results official now in Class 75 from our Morgan Division. It has been the Hunter Pleasure Championship. Our champion will congratulate 749. Its opponent is Moralio. Lilo Tarter, the owner and rider from El Cajon, California. Reserve champion to number 642, National Treasure, Courtney Carrera, the owner and rider from North Clarendon, Vermont. Third award is 649, Eric Church. Amanda Krasicki shows for Rain Dance Stables in Sequoia, New York. And the fourth award of 489, it's Hillwood Irish Rose. Brandy Cario shows for Deborah Lucas of Plainville, Massachusetts. Here's another look at our reserve champion. We'll congratulate National Treasure, Courtney Carrera, the owner and rider from North Clarendon, Vermont. Down victory lane, our Morgan Hunter Pleasure Champion, also our reigning World Grand Champion for both amateurs and open. Give it up for opponents Moralio and Lila Tarter, all the way from El Cajon, California.
All right, guys, during this next class, we're going to give you a chance to be the judge, and I've also got three people that have joined us in center ring as spectator judges for this class. It's going to be our five-gated Show Pleasure Championship. We'll put the instructions up on the big screen for you guys, but we want you to pick your winner. You will text the word winner, then a space, then whatever the back number is for your favorite in the class, and you'll send that text to 22333. So again, the number to text is 22333. You'll text the word winner, then a space, and then the back number that the rider's wearing. Don't pay attention to what's on the screen. That's not correct. We want you to send winner, space, then the back number. So if you think it's 537, you would put winner, then leave a space, and then put 537, and text it to 22333. All right, we've got our amateur judges ready to go, too. We're going to take a look at this five-gated Show Pleasure Championship, and at the end of the class, we'll let you meet these spectator judges and find out who they pick. Class is complete. Judging underway at the trot, please.
Walk, please. At a walk, please. Set him up and slow gate. Rack on now, let him rack. Thank you, riders. Down to the walk, please. At a walk, please. Canter, please. Show at the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Reverse and trot, please. Walk, please. At a walk, please. Trot, please. Oh, sorry. Set him up and slow gate. My apologies. Walk, please. And then set him up and slow gate. Rack on now, let him rack. And thank you, riders, down to the walk, please. At a walk, please. Canter Please. And thank you very much, riders. Down to the walk, please. And thank you very much, riders. One last look of a call for the lineup, please. The five-gated show pleasure championship headed to the lineup.
So our judge, Renee Lavery, is marking her card in this championship class. Our spectator judges are making their decisions. You can place your vote. Who do you think won the class? Send the word winner, text the word winner, then a space followed by the number that the rider's wearing and send it to 22333. So text the word winner, followed by a space, and then the rider's back number and send it to 22333. Let us know who you think won the class. All right. So Renee's turned in her card. Have you guys marked yours? All right. Dad, I'm gonna let you introduce us to everybody here. What's your name?
My name is Bill.
Now, who do you have with you?
I have my wife, Nelia, and daughter, Giselle.
All right. Now, they just moved back from San Diego area or from California, just moved back to this area. This is your first horse show, right? And you rode a horse this morning. You did the pony rides, right?
Yes.
All right, I'm going to let you. You seem to really be paying the most attention. Who do you think won the class?
734.
Number 734. That's who you got winning the class? All right. What about Mom and Dad? Who did you guys pick?
750.
And?
750.
And 750. So a little dissent in the family. I know your grandparents are sitting up there, too, so I don't know if they picked along with you guys or not. But Todd, can you tell us who the crowd picked?
Mark, the crowd picked 750.
So the crowd picked 750. Mom and Dad picked 750. So Todd, we'll go to you to find out who the judge picked.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the crowd and our celebrity judges were all right. It is 750 winning the class. Welcome them to the winner's circle. Fort Chiswell's Hot Kiss, Catherine Foy, the owner and rider from Kingston, New Hampshire. Our winner, as picked by our celebrity judges as well as the crowd today. Second place, we'll congratulate 537. It's for Chiswell's Secret Kiss. Sharon Stoltz, the owner rider from East Hampton, Connecticut. And the third award is 734. It's Tornado's Tempest. Pamela Fettig shows for Geraldine Meaner of Glenridge, New Jersey.
So all three of these family members, all three spectator judges going home with a big E prize pack. Now, Giselle, I've got good news. You said you wanted to ride a horse. Is that correct?
Yes.
All right. In your prize pack, there's a gift certificate. There's about a dozen local training facilities and stables that have donated free riding and driving lessons. So you're going to get to take advantage of one of those. So congratulations. Good job, guys.
And here's a look one more time at our reserve champion in the five-gated show pleasure championship, Fort Chiswell's Secret Kiss and Sharon Stoltz. Here comes our champion as a give him a hand as they head down victory lane one more time. Fort Chiswell's Hot Kiss and Catherine Foy. Not only our judges pick, also our crowd pick and celebrity judges pick. Congratulations, Catherine. Next on the schedule is class number 77. It is the Wachat Pleasure. Class is sponsored today by Rocking Horse Farm. Class is complete. Judging underway at the trot or jog, please. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Reverse and continue at the walk, please. Trot or jog, please. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. And thank you very much. Walk, trot, pleasure. We'll call for the lineup, please. If you would, join us center ring for the lineup facing your ringmaster. Attendants can make your way in once we're lined up. Results official now in class number 77 has been our Walk Trot Pleasure class sponsored today by Rocking Horse Farm. And we'll congratulate our winner, number 311. What's up, Chuck? Samantha Cole shows for James and Anastasia Cole of Warren, Vermont. Second award to 743 is Champion Gone Platinum. Corey Schaefer shows for Aaron McCracken of Hardwick, New Jersey. In a third, number 648, that's Mantic Excalibur. Mia McDermott shows for Rain Dance Stables in Sequoia. Fourth place, number 670, Airspace. Paige Conroy shows for Wentz Stables in Orfield, Pennsylvania. Fifth, number 246, AMHF Baldumask. Hayden Morris shows for Ashley Morris of Barrie, Vermont. And the sixth award is 671, Gotham Stone. Alex Sabin shows for Christopher Sabin of Greenfield, Massachusetts. Here they come down Victory Lane. We'll congratulate once again our winner, the Walk Trot Pleasure. Once again, it's What's Up Chuck and Samantha Cole. Next up on the schedule is class number 79. This is the Three Gated Country Junior Exhibitor. Expecting six. You can come right in. So just a reminder, those of you standing along the rail, please do keep arms, heads, legs, whips, and children outside of the arena at all times. Thank you. And complete underway at the trot, please. Three Gated Country Junior Exhibitor underway at the trot, please. Extend the trot, please. Show it the extended trot. Walk, please. At a walk, please. And stand, please. Walk, please. At a walk, please. Canter, please. Show at the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Reverse and trot, please. Extend the trot, please. Show it the extended trot. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Halt and stand, please. Walk, please. Canter, please. Show the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. And thank you very much, riders. We're asking to ride right into center ring and line up. This has been our three-gated country pleasure for the junior exhibitors.
Don't forget, if you have questions about the horse show as you watch it, be sure to text your questions to the number 22333. Just put the word Big E, then a space, and then your question, and send it to 22333. So one of the questions that has come in asks, how much does it cost to enter the horse show? Well, there's different costs associated with different classes, but we'll use this class for an example. The entry fee for this class was $20. There's probably another $48 or $50 in fees that go with each horse, and then $110 if you want a stall. But just the basic entry fee for this class was $20.
Thank you, Mark. Results official now for class number 79. It is our three-gated country pleasure for the junior exhibitor. First place, the Blue Ribbon Honors will congratulate 508, its champion, Extremely Fortnut. Bella Jett shows for Ashley Wheaton of Enfield. Second place, we'll congratulate 618, the Blues Master, Patrick McMurtry of Orfield, Pennsylvania, the owner and rider. Third place is 631, champion Imagine If, Kira Casey of Flemington, New Jersey, the owner and rider. Fourth, number 550, Undulata's Mystery Man, Jenna Gear of Syracuse, New York, the owner rider. Into fifth, 542, He's Mama's Boy, Beatrix Jordan of Amesbury, Massachusetts, aboard. And the sixth award is 621, champion Santa Ana Wind, Haley Sheldon, shows for James Sheldon of Hillsboro, New Jersey. Here they come, making their pass into Big E Victory Lane. Please congratulate once again your winner, champion Extremely Fortunate, Bella Jett, road to victory for Ashley Wheaton of Enfield, New Hampshire. Next up on the schedule is class number 80. It's the Adult Western Saddle Seat Equitation. Lone entry making their way in. Class is complete. Judging underway at the trot, please. Adult Saddle Seat Equitation Championship at the trot, please. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Canter, please. Show it the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Reverse and trot, please. walk, please. At a walk, please. Canter, please. Show at the canter. Thank you, Ryder. Down to the walk, please. And we're asking a trot right into center ring and line up. This has been the Adult Saddle Seat Equitation Championship.
Another question that's come in asks the difference between a trot and an extended trot. Well, an extended trot is pretty much what it says. It's an extension of the trot, but it's faster, stronger, and bolder, a fuller extension of stride to obtain the desired speed, so the horse is covering more ground at the trot. It's executed in a highly collected manner, but that's the difference between an extended trot and a trot.
Results official now in class number 80. It is our Adult Western Seat Equitation Championship. Our champion will congratulate number 672. It's Jennifer Sullivan of Pembroke, Massachusetts. Here's another look at the winner of the Adult Western Seat Saddle Seat Equitation Championship. We'll congratulate Jennifer Sullivan of Pembroke, Massachusetts.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, now's your chance to catch a Big E t-shirt and also get a free riding or driving lesson at one of our area's local stables. We're getting ready to bring the tractor in for a little ring conditioning and to drag the ring, but we're also bringing our t-shirt tossers in. We're going to play a little music, let you do a little dancing, let you get their attention. Catch one of the t-shirts, not only a great souvenir, but also they include a gift certificate for a free riding or driving lesson in this area.
Like a fool, I went and stayed too long. I'm wondering if your love's still strong. Ooh, baby, here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours. Then that time I went and said goodbye. Now I'm back and not ashamed. Yeah.
right, buddy, get up. Hey.
Hey, so if you didn't catch a t-shirt and get a gift certificate during that ring drag, you can always go online to find a local barn in your area. Go to UPHAonline.com, search your local area for a barn that offers riding lessons and driving lessons here in this area.
Thank you very much, Mark. Next up on the schedule is class number 82. Returning to the Morgan Division is the Classic Pleasure Driving Championship. We are expecting three in this one. Class is complete and underway at the Pleasure Trot, please. Up to the road trot, please. At the road trot. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Reverse and continue at the walk, please. Pleasure trot, please. Show it the pleasure trot.
The Morgan horse, born and bred not only in the USA, but right here in New England. Much like the American saddlebred, the Morgan horse worked beside their owners during the week that took him to market on Saturday and church on Sundays. A very versatile horse, not only a great horse for driving, but also riding, shown in many disciplines throughout the equestrian world. When they grew the most in popularity here in New England, they were pulling stagecoaches throughout New England, and by the mid-1850s were also setting trotting records in the infancy of harness racing in the U.S.
Up to the road trot, please. At a road trot.
The Morgan horse that started right here in New England can now be found in all 50 states and more than 20 different foreign countries.
Now we're asking to return to the Pleasure Trot, please, drivers. And Pleasure Trot right into center ring and lineup. This has been the Morgan Classic Pleasure Driving Championship.
Well, this brings us up to our next trivia question. Where was Justin Morgan from? You can text your answer to 22333. It's either Springfield, MA. Text Springfield, MA to 22333. Randolph, Vermont. Text Randolph, VT. Or Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. That's OKC, OK. Text one of those keywords to the number 22333. So again, Springfield, Massachusetts. You need to text the word Springfield, M-A, all one word. Randolph, Vermont, Randolph, V-T, or Oklahoma City, O-K-C, O-K. Text it to 22333.
Results official now in class number 82, our Morgan Classic Pleasure Driving Championship. We'll congratulate our champion, number 206, Indian Creek Splendid Son, Joanne Bush of Belchertown, Massachusetts, the owner and driver. Second place reserve champion to number 535, it's Do-Re-Mi, Kendra Traynor, the owner and driver from Pembroke, Massachusetts. Third to 495, it's Sydney Dawson, Robert Ratio of Brooklyn, Connecticut, the owner and driver. Here's another look at the reserve champion for our Morgan Classic Pleasure Driving Championship, Do-Re-Mi and Kendra Traynor. Here comes the champion, Indian Creek Splendid Son and Joanne Bush of Belchertown, Massachusetts. Next up on the schedule is class number 83. It is the Hackney Pony Country Pleasure Driving Championship. Class sponsored today by Ricky and Cheryl Innes of Summers, Connecticut. Expecting two in this one.
So again, we told you earlier that the Morgan horse breed is named for a guy, Justin Morgan. Where was Justin Morgan from? That's our trivia question. Those instructions up on the big screen. Springfield, MA. Text that word to 22333 if you think it was Springfield, Massachusetts, Randolph, VT for Randolph, Vermont, or OKC, OK. It's Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. Text one of those keywords to 22333. And our trivia question, where was Justin Morgan from? We've talked a lot about our American Saddlebreds and Morgan horses today, but this class comes from our Hackney Pony Division.
Judging underweight, the Pleasure Trot, please.
Where the Morgan horses and American Saddlebreds were born and bred right here in the USA. The origins of the Hackney come from Norfolk, England. The horses originally called Norfolk Trotters and selectively bred for elegant style and speed. By the 1800s, the Hackney was the ultimate driving machine in both Britain and America, with the very first Hackneys imported into Philadelphia in 1878.
Up to the road trot, please. At the road trot. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Halt and stand, please. Walk, please. Reverse and continue at the walk, please.
So since this is a pleasure class, our judge asking him to halt and also to walk. That's part of the judge's evaluation in any of our pleasure class. The manners of these ponies or these horses in any pleasure class, including in our Hackney division.
Halt and stand, please. Pleasure trot, please. Show it the pleasure trot.
A judge not only looking for manners, but still looking for that great action from our Hackney ponies. That's the hallmark of the Hackney breed. That great action for a small-framed Hackney pony. Still high-stepping and exciting in the show ring. Very distinctive for the Hackney pony. That's still part of these ponies, even in the pleasure division.
Up to the road trot, please. At a road trot. And thank you very much, drivers. Return to the pleasure trot, please. And we'll ask a pleasure trot right in the center ring and line up. Results official now for Class 83 of Hackney Pony Country Pleasure Driving Championship. Class sponsored once again by Ricky and Cheryl Ennis of Summers, Connecticut. And we'll award the championship tricolor this afternoon to 516, the Fresh Prince. Carol Wesson of Monson, Massachusetts, the owner and driver. Reserve tricolor goes to number 517. It's Red Sox Nation. Donna White of Fitchburg, Massachusetts, the owner and driver. Here's another look at our reserve champion in our Hackney Pony Country Pleasure Driving. Congratulate once again Red Sox Nation and Donna White. And here comes the champion taking their turn into Big E Victory Lane, the Fresh Prince. Carol Wesson of Monson, Massachusetts, the owner and driver. Next on the schedule is class number 86. It's the New England Horsemen's Council Pleasure Open. Six entries can make their way in. Class is complete. Judging underway at the Pleasure Trot, please. Walk, please. Add a walk, please. Canter, please. Show with the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Reverse and trot, please. Thank you. Thank you, riders. Down to the walk, please. Canter, please. Show with the canter. Walk, please. At a walk, please. And thank you very much, riders. We'll ask you to trot right into center ring and line up. This has been the New England Horsemen's Council Pleasure Open.
So we'll give you one more chance to vote on our trivia question. Where was Justin Morgan from? Is it Springfield, Massachusetts, Randolph, Vermont, or Oklahoma City, Oklahoma? Those instructions up on the big screen right now. It's your last chance to vote in our trivia question this afternoon. Where was Justin Morgan from? Morgan horses are named for Justin Morgan. Where was Justin Morgan from originally? Springfield, MA, Randolph, VT, or OKC, OK. Send that to 22333. Todd, I'm over here with the Capillo family from Suffield, Connecticut. They've joined us for Big E today. They say they try to make it every year to Big E, and they're seated in Section 16, and I'm going to let them see how much they know and how much they've been listening to the Morgan horse. First of all, what's your favorite part of Big E? What do you like coming for?
The blueberry pie.
The blueberry pie. So they stopped at the main building first and got the blueberry pie. But you've enjoyed the horse show too, right?
Yeah.
All right. So do you think Justin Morgan, who the Morgan horse is named after, was Justin Morgan from Springfield, right here in Springfield, from Randolph, Vermont, or from Oklahoma City?
Springfield.
From Springfield. That's his answer. Todd, what does the crowd say the answer is?
Sorry, Mark. Yes, most of the group thinks that Randolph, Vermont is where Justin Morgan is from.
Well, it's kind of a trick question. Justin Morgan was born here in Springfield. This is where he's from. He moved to Randolph, Vermont, and that's where he bought the horse that later became the foundation for the Morgan horse. But he is from Springfield, Massachusetts. So congratulations. You're going to win a Big E prize pack today. Now, in that prize pack is a gift certificate good for one free riding or driving lesson. There's about 10 different barns in the area throughout New England, or maybe more than that, about a dozen, that are offering free riding and driving lessons to people who have these certificates. So I'm going to give you and your sister both one of those. And anybody who wants to, you can find a local stable in your area to go to for riding or driving lessons. A great online resource. Just go to uphaonline.com, and you can find stables in your area where you can take riding or driving lessons. Again, that website is uphaonline.com.
Thank you very much, Mark. We do have official results now of Class 86, our New England Horsemen's Council Pleasure Open. First place in Blue Ribbon Honors this afternoon goes to number 511, Row and Knees, A Charming Kiss. Quinn Mertier shows for Alyssa Medico of Merrimack, New Hampshire. Second place to number 466. That's Flintlock's Envy. It's an entry of Elaine Gregory of Brookfield, Vermont, with Chloe Deeb aboard. Third award of 544, Intrepid Asset, Alexandra Stewart, shows for Catherine and Brian Stewart of Cream Ridge, New Jersey. Fourth place is 613, Kazoom, Anita Grieco, shows for Caitlin Flannery of Plymouth, Massachusetts. Fifth place is 624, Queens Out of Bounds, Ivy Murphy of Annandale, New Jersey, the owner rider. Sixth to number 490, that's Iron Maiden's Voyage. Christina Fuller shows for Brandy Cario of Middleborough, Massachusetts. And the seventh award to 627, Flamin' Hurricane, Andrea Mader, the owner rider from Bedminster, New Jersey. Here's another look at our winner for the New England Horsemen's Council Pleasure Open. We'll congratulate once again Roe and Me's A Charming Kiss. It's an entry of Alyssa Medico of Merrimack, New Hampshire, with Quinn Mertier aboard. Next up on the schedule is Class 87 from the American Saddlebred Division. It is the Show Pleasure Driving Championship. Lone entry making their way in. Class is complete. Judging underway at the trot, please. Extend the trot, please. Show the extended trot. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Reverse and continue at the walk, please. Trot, please. Show the trot. Extend the trot, please. Show it the extended trot. And return to the trot, please. And thank you very much. We ask you to line up center ring. This has been our Saddlebred Show Pleasure Driving Championship. Results official now in Class 87. It's the Saddlebred Saddlebred Show Pleasure Driving Championship. Our champion will congratulate number 501. It's Mark Me Too. Lisa DiNozzo shows. Here's another look at the winner of our Saddlebred Show Pleasure Driving Championship. Give it up one more time for Mark Me Too. Lisa DiNozzo of Arrington, Massachusetts, the owner and driver, our champion for 2018. Next up on the schedule is class number 88. It is the Park Pleasure for the junior and novice horse. Lone entry making their way in right now.
Hey, don't forget, if you've got questions about the horse show, questions about what you're watching, you can text them to us. Text the word Big E followed by a space and then your question to the number 22333. We'll get those questions and try to answer them. So again, you've got questions, we'll try to have answers. Just text the word Big E, then a space, and then your question to the number 22333. Those instructions are up on the screen now.
So we are complete and underway at the trot, please. Our Park Pleasure Junior and Novice Horse underway at the trot, please. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Canter, please. Show it the canter. Walk, please. At a walk, please. Reverse and trot, please. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Canter, please. Show at the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. And thank you very much. I ask you to join us in center ring for the lineup. This has been the Park Pleasure for the Junior and Novice Horse Championship. That's right. Give them a hand as they head to the lineup. Last look at them before we do results.
So some of the questions coming in ask, how do I know if you're judging the horse or rider? Well, pretty much every class we're judging the horse unless we say it's an equitation class. In an equitation class, the rider is being judged instead of the horse. But for the vast majority of our classes, we're evaluating the horse. In equitation classes, we evaluate the rider.
Our results official now in Class 88, our $200 Park Pleasure Junior Novice Horse Championship. Our champion will congratulate 655. It's Nutcracker Omen. Emily Nickel shows for Bob and Peggy King of Fairport, New York. Here we come down Victory Lane, our Park Pleasure Junior Novice Horse Champion, Nutcracker's Omen and Emily Nickel. Next up on the schedule, class number 89 from the Morgan Division, it is the English Pleasure Junior Exhibitors.
So another one of the questions that's come in ask, how do they get the horse's tail so long? Well, they work real hard on it. Tails are a prized possession on horses and a big part of their appearance, not only brushing them out and conditioning them well, but a lot of times you'll see folks tie them up as they leave the ring to help the horse keep from stepping on them and keep it clean when they go to the stall. And I'll admit, sometimes they put extensions in there. Some horses can grow better tails than others, just like some people grow better hair than others. And sometimes the horse needs an extension in their tail to make it look fuller and longer. But a lot of pride and care goes into taking care of those horses' tails.
Road trot, please. Up to the road trot. Walk, please. Add a walk, please. Okay. canter, please. Show it the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Reverse and pleasure trot, please. Up to the road trot, please. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Canter, please. Show it the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. And thank you very much, Ryder. We'll ask you to join us at center ring for the lineup. The results official now in class number 89. It has been our Morgan English pleasure for the junior exhibitor. We'll congratulate our winner, number 625. It's NAS Rickenbacker. Caitlin Salimo shows for Megan Harrison of Flemington, New Jersey.
So another one of the questions that's come in, ask what a horse's favorite color is. I don't know that horses have favorite colors, but it's worth noting that horses, like some animals, aren't colorblind. They have two-color vision, where most humans have three-color vision. So in other words, horses naturally see blue and green colors, the spectrum of the color variations, but cannot distinguish red. So two-color vision in horses, three colors for most humans. They're not colorblind, but I don't know that horses have a favorite color. If you've got questions, you can text them to us. Text the word Big E with a space followed by your question to 22333.
Here's another look at the winner, the Morgan English pleasure for the junior exhibitor, NAS Rickenbacker and Caitlin Salimo. She showed the victory today for Megan Harrison. Next up on the schedule is class number 90. It is the $250 three-gated park horse championship. Lone entry making their way in. pass is complete and judging underway at the trap, please. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Canter, please. Show at the canter. Walk, please. At a walk, please. Reverse and trot, please. Walk, please. At a walk, please. Canter, please. Show at the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. And thank you very much, Riders West. Get you ride right into center ring and line up. Hey, results official now in class number 90. It has been the $250 three-gated parkour championship. Our champion will congratulate number 504. It's the King's Watchman. Alexander Frangiosa, the owner and rider from Westwood, Massachusetts.
So one of the questions came in asking what kind of bit this horse was wearing. So somebody already a little familiar with horses wants to know what kind of bit this horse is wearing. We believe probably two bits, both a curb and a snaffle, one to elevate the head and the other to give him a little balance and control. But wearing both a curb and snaffle bit is what we believe from here. That's what kind of bit this horse is wearing. But you'll find different bits in different divisions throughout our show.
Here's another look at our champion in the three-gated park horse championship, the King's Watchman and Alexander Frangiosa. Next up on the schedule, class number 91, it is our Open Country Pleasure Championship. Expecting five in this one. Class is complete and underway at the trot, please. Underway at the trot, please. Walk, please. At a walk, please.
Canter.
Canter, please. Show at the canter. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Halt and stand, please. Walk, please. And a walk. Reverse and trot, please. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Canter, please. Show it the canter. Thank you. walk, please. At a walk, please. Halt and stand, please. Walk, please. And thank you very much, riders. We're asking to pick up the trot, please, and trot right into center ring and line up.
Hey, so don't forget, if you have questions about the horse show you're watching, you can text your questions to 22333. That's two twos and three threes. Just put the word Big E, then a space, followed by your question, and send it to 22333. Now, we've had several questions come in about the care and training of horses, so I've come down here to the rail in front of Section 23 with Tara Goosley, one of our trainers who has a horse in this class, to let her hopefully answer a couple of these questions. Now, you people are obsessed with the tails on these horses, the length of them, how shiny they are, how good they look. You're wanting recommendations. I'm thinking probably not for your horses at home, but maybe your own hair, not saying you've got horse hair. But a lot of people want to know what products are you using on the care and conditioning of these horses' tails, Tara?
Well, just like people's hair, we're going to shampoo and condition and try to keep them clean. We'll keep the tails braided up for everyday purposes so they're not stepping and pulling out their hair, and we'll leave a few wispies out that they can swish the flies away and be comfortable. One of our favorite products is Cowboy Magic. We love that in the tail, just a little bit works great, and I know some girls in the barn might want to use it in their hair too, so there's your hair tip for the day.
All right, the other question is how long, and this is a real general question. I know it's probably a very detailed answer, but we'll get as general as we can. But in general, how long does it take to train an American Saddlebred?
I think the Saddlebreds are a very intelligent breed, and just like any other breed, it's going to be training over years. I think you don't ever really finish training a horse. You continue to improve and grow with it over time. That being said, you know, a lot of the Saddlebreds are entering into the ring as young as 2 and 3 years old, but really once they're getting to that 5-year-old, 7-year-old year, they're really getting strong in their division and really solid in there, and then they can continue showing and being in training well into their late teens and some into their early 20s. So it's really to have a good, well-trained horse, it's a lifelong thing that you're working on.
So I mean, I would use it almost like your kids. I mean, training them, I mean, I was potty trained within just a few months. My brother was like 5 years old. I mean, you never know. It's based on intelligence, I would say, right?
So you're saying you're smarter than your brother, or?
Absolutely. All right, Tara, thank you very much. Again, send your questions to 22333, the word Big E, followed by a space, and then your question.
Thank you, Mark, and thank you, Tara, for that insightful view on training a horse. Mark, we don't want to know any more about training you. Results official now in class number 91. This is our Open Country Pleasure Championship, our opportunity class. We'll congratulate our winner today, number 668. It's She's All the Rage, Lo Kaprensky. Shows for Michelle Rivard of Lititz, Pennsylvania. Second place, we'll congratulate 672. It's Bright Fire. Courtney Grant shows for Jennifer Sullivan of Pembroke, Massachusetts. In a third, 497, it's Renaissance Amore. Wendy Noyes Port chose for Nicodemus Villa of Union Center, Connecticut. At our fourth award of 545, it's Night Ops. Olivia Marker Pittock shows for Alan Lanau. Here's another look at our reserve champion. We'll congratulate once again Brightfire, Courtney Grant, rode for Jennifer Sullivan. Here comes the champion once again. She's all the rage. Lo Kaprinsky chose for Michelle Rivard.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be your chance to get another t-shirt or maybe a free riding or driving lesson at one of our local New England stables. We've got about a dozen different stables and farms around the New England area that have donated riding and driving lessons. If you don't catch one of the t-shirts and get one of the certificates, you can always go to uphaonline.com, a great resource from the United Professional Horsemen's Association. Go to uphaonline.com to find a local stable in your area that offers riding and driving lessons. Here come our t-shirt tossers. And again, each of these t-shirts has a gift certificate for a free riding or driving lesson here in New England. Thank you.
Next up on the schedule, class number 92. It is our junior and novice harness pony class lone entry making their way in. Pass is complete and underway at the park trot, please. Show your pony. Park trot, please. Back to the park trot. Reverse and continue at the park trot, please. Show your pony. Return to the park trot, please, and we'll ask you to park trot right into center ring and line up. This has been the Junior and Novice Harness Ponies. The results official now in our junior and novice harness pony class number 92. Winners number 527, the Prophet LF, Brandy Snow, drives for Margot Garish of Gorham, Maine. Here's another look at the winner, the junior and novice harness pony winner. We'll congratulate once again the Prophet LF, Randy Snow, shows for Margot Garish of Gorham, Maine. Next up on the schedule is class number 93, first of two remaining classes on our afternoon. It is the Open Western Pleasure Opportunity class, expecting two. Class is complete. Judging underway at the jog, please. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Lope, please. Show at the lope, please. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Reverse and continue at the walk, please. Lope, please. At the lope, please. Down to the jog, please. At the jog, please. And thank you very much, Ryder. We'll ask you to jog right into center ring and line up, please. The results official now in class 93, our Open Western Pleasure Opportunity class. We'll congratulate our winner number 496. It's Celtic Hill Forevermore. Ian Beck shows out of Scotland, Connecticut. Here's another look at the winner, Open Western Pleasure Opportunity Class. It's Celtic Hill Forevermore, Eddie and Beck. Next up, final class of our afternoon schedule. It is class number 94 from the American Saddlebred Division. It is the five-gated Novice and Junior Horse Open. Expecting three in this one. Class is complete and underway at the trot, please. Walk, please. At a walk, please.
Five-gated horses are the epitome of saddlebred athleticism and skill, the peacocks of the show ring. That's what the American Saddlebred's known as, and you see it right here in this class.
Set them up and slow gate.
The American Saddlebred is one of only two horses in the world that perform five gates, the walk, trot, and canter. They also do the slow gate and the rack. You'll notice as these horses went to a slow gate, the riders are no longer posting or bouncing in the saddle, but enjoying a smooth ride.
Back on now, let them rack.
Now I want you to watch closely. Both the slow gate and the rack are four-beat gates. Only 1 foot is striking the ground at a time. That's what's giving them a smooth ride. So watch real closely and watch their feet as they strike the ground.
Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. All walk, please. Canter, please. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Reverse and trot, please.
So this class is a five-gated class for novice or junior horses. Novice horses means they have not won three blue ribbons yet in their career. Junior horse means that they're 4 years of age and under. So these horses, many of them just beginning in their show ring career, either novice, having not yet won three blue ribbons, or junior, 4 years of age and under. for our junior or novice five-gated class. Walk, please. Down to the walk, please. Another thing about our horses and riders, they love to know that you love what they're doing. So if you see somebody you like or somebody you think's a winner in the class, don't be afraid to yell for them and cheer for them. They love to hear from you, and they love to know you like them.
Set them up and slow gate. Down to the walk, please. Canter, please. Show it the canter. Walk, please. And thank you very much. One last look as you head to the lineup. Here we go. The five-gated novice and junior horse open. We've called for the lineup. The results are official now in class number 94, our five-gated novice and junior horse open. Winning the class, we'll congratulate number 502, it's Intuition. David Cater rode to victory today for Cedar Ledge Farm in Wethersfield, Connecticut. Second place is 742, it's Manhattan Ice. Aaron McCracken shows for Karen Longo of Montville, New Jersey. And in third, 528, it's McLean. Amy Champion shows for Jody Goff of Wilton, New York. Another look at the winner of the five-gated novice and junior open. We'll congratulate once again Intuition. David Cater rode to victory for Cedar Ledge Farm in Wethersfield, Connecticut. Ladies and gentlemen, that does bring the curtain down on the afternoon performance here on the Saturday at the Big E. We get back underway tonight at 6 o'clock for a full evening of Saddlebred Morgan Roadster and Hackney Pony showing. Looking forward to seeing you back in here tonight at 6 o'clock. Enjoy the rest of your day here at the fair. Good afternoon, everyone.